أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله، صلى الله عليك وعلى أهل بيتك المظلومين، صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله وعلى ابن عمك علي المرتضى عليه السلام، صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله وعلى ابنتك فاطمة الزهراء عليها السلام، صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آل المجتبى عليه السلام، صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله، صلى الله عليك يا ابن رسول الله، يا رحمة الله الواسعة ويا باب نجاة الأمة، ما خاب من تمسك بكم وأمن من لجأ إليكم، يا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي فنفوز فوزا عظيما. قال الله تعالى في كتابه المجيد: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فأما من ثقلت موازينه فهو في عيشة راضية. آمنا بالله، صدق الله العلي العظيم. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. When we look about the topic of al-khayr, doing that which is good, then we come to know that the topic is very wide. Our scholars have discussed it in length, and we find the discussion about khayr in the Holy Quran, as well as the many ahadith from Ma'sumina alayhi wassalam. When we look, for example, at Surah Al-Qari'ah, in Surah Al-Qari'ah, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about amal thaqeel. And he says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. Just near the end of the surah. And then the opposite is it, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ. So when we look at the ayah, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ, here we find that Allah the Almighty says and tells us about a truth which will happen to each and every one of you, brothers and sisters, each and every one of us, we will come to this reality. Either we will leave this world with عَمَلْ ثَقِيل, or we are going to leave this world with عَمَلْ خَفِيف. As for those who leave this world with amal thaqeel, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ, those ones, when they leave this world and their scale of a'mal, their mizan of ahasanat, if their mizan is going to be thaqeel, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ, then فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةِ الرَّاضِيَةِ. That, or such kind of a person, will reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with happiness. He will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his amal will be, insha'Allah, making him to be among the righteous people. To do amal which is khair will make you to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with load, heavy of load deeds which we have done in this world. And we need to do a lot. Those who will return with amal khafif, فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ, as for the one who will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with amal khafif, very little, a'mal, we have not done a lot, فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ, then of course they will be in loss, they will be in regret, and there will be no any chance which will be given for each and every one of us to come back to this world. So what we need from this ayah in Surah Al-Qari'ah, فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ, we need to make sure we do a lot of amal khair in order for us to be among those people. Their mizan of hasanat will be heavy. Our loads of hasanat, we need to make them plenty in order for us, inshallah, to be accepted and to be pleased by what we are going to see there. When we talk about khair in this majlis, when we honor and we remember marhum Muhammad Moledina, then we come to know that indeed he was a person who in his life did a lot of amal khair. Jazahullahu khair al-jaza. May Allah reward him abundantly. And when we look at the ahadith from Ma'asumina alayhimu salam, we come to know that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, it has been narrated in the book Bihar al-Anwar, and this hadith also has been quoted by Sheikh Muhammad Ar-Ray Shahri in his book Mizan Al-Hikmah. He mentions in the chapter of doing Al-Khair, he says that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has said, man yazra khayran yushik an yuhsida khayra. Man yazra khayra. Anyone who plants khayr, anyone who plants that which is good, yushik and yuhsida khayra, he will also cultivate that is khayr, that which is good. And when we look at this hadith, we come to know that when you do khayr, you expect to get only khayr, nothing else. When you cultivate that which is good, you will harvest that which is good. And it is here we need to understand that when you plant and you dig the earth, ukilima, even in Swahili, ukilima, ukapanda kheri, utavuna kheri. Ukipanda kheri, utavuna kheri. When you plant that which is khair, you will get only khair. And Imam Amirul Mu'minin alayhi salam, he says again in the same book, Mizan al-Hikmah, fi'ilul khayri dhakhiratun baqiyatun wa thamaratun zakiya. Fi'ilul khayr, the act of doing something which is good, dhakhiratun baqiya, it is a long-lasting investment. Your action of doing something which is good, this is a long-lasting investment. It will remain until the day of judgment. وَثَمَرَةٌ زَاكِيَةٌ, and it is a good fruit which people will get to get the benefit out of it. And again, Amirul Mu'minin says, غَارِسُ شَجَرَةِ الْخَيْرِ يَجْتَنِيهَا أَحْلَى ثَمَرًا. The person who cultivates the tree of good deeds, he will harvest the fruit which will be good for him, because he has done something which is good. And again, when we come and think about doing khair, sometimes people think it is a difficult thing. How can we manage to do khair while the world which we are living in is full of shar? How can I do good deeds to people while there are many people who are bad? How can I do good deeds to others while others, even they don't say thank you to you? Why do I need to trouble myself? Amirul Mu'minin alayhi salam say, al khayru ashalu min fi'li shar. Remember all the time, when you do that which is good, it's easy for you than to do that which is bad. Al khayru ashalu min fi'li shar. When you want to do something good, remember it is easy for you to do that which is good than to do that which is not good. But when we ask what are the factors which make people to do that which is good while we live in this world, and we see that there are many people who are not able to do that which is good, even though Amirul Mu'minin alayhi salam says, it is easy to do that which is good than to do that which is bad. It is not easy to do that which is bad. You need a lot of preparations for you to do something which is bad. But that which is good, it is easy for you. So what are the factors? We come to know that from Ma'asumina alayhim wassalam, number one factor which make people to be able to do that which is good is fear of Allah the Almighty. When you know that a day will come, you will be made to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That day when Amirul Mu'minin in his munajat, he says, Mawlaya ya Mawlaya, antal Mawla wa ana al-abd. Wahal yarhamul abda illa al-Mawla. Mawlaya ya Mawlaya, you are the Lord. I am that slave of you. And indeed, no one will show mercy, and there will be no any other merciful Lord except the one who shows mercy to his slave. We know a day will come when we will be returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we know we will be alone, because that is the day which yawma yafirru al-mar'u min akhihi wa ummihi wa abihi wa sahibatihi wa banihi likulli imri'in minhum yawma idhin sha'nu yughni. Everyone will be busy on that day. You look left and you look right, in front of you, behind you, you see everyone is busy trying to find a shelter. So the only thing which will help us in order for us to be saved, number one, is fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And fear of Allah makes you to do khair, because you know a day will come when some people will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they don't have many good deeds. But some will be among the people who have done good deeds, but because they have taken the rights of someone here and there, those good deeds which they have done, the good deeds which they have done will be taken away from their investments. Because why? You have taken people's right. Haqqun nas is very important for us to look at it. So number one, we need to make sure fear of Allah is always in front of us in order for us to be able to do good deeds. Number two, it is the knowledge of good. When you know that to do good is good, not only to you, but even to the people you're doing that good to them. And even not only to them, but the act of goodness itself is a good thing. That knowledge, when you have it, it will make you to be able to continue to do that which is good. But there is an issue here. And the issue is, how can we continue to do that which is good while sometimes we are surrounded with the people who discourage us even to do that which is good? You want to do good. You have prepared to do good. But when you want to do good, there are people who are telling you not to do, because you don't know whether this particular individual will do good himself. Is he a Muslim? Is he not? Is he a Shi'i or not? All these things sometimes stop us from doing that which is good. But the knowledge of goodness itself makes you to be a person who can be able to continue to do that which is good. Now, when we come to know about all these factors in terms of goodness itself and the reasons and the factors why we do good, then we come to know that the act of doing something which is good, the person who does something which is khair, he becomes sometimes khair than the khair itself. Mfanyaji wa khairi, yeye mwenyewe ni khairi kuliko ile khairi yenyewe. Allahu Akbar. In a hadith we read this, that when you do that which is good, that which is khair, you become better than the action itself and that which you wanted to do. And this is actually what we look at the life of our brother, marhum now, Muhammad Moledina. Marhum, subhanallah. We saw the photo of marhum just before the end of the Shahar Ramadan. And when you come to know that his death is shahada wallah, when he passed away on the 28th of Shahar Ramadan, when he was observing fasting, subhanallah, subhanallah. He was observing fasting. And after doing a lot of good, and he was a person who used to do good deeds. And then you come to know that he was going for iftar, Allahu Akbar. Then you know that this man was a man of khair himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested him, has tested his family, has tested all the people who knew him, and even those who did not know him very well. When I came to know that marhum Muhammad Mulidina rahmatullahi alayh, he was a man always, always was after silatul rahim. Then you come to know indeed he was a man of khair himself. Because silatul rahim is each and everything. Silatul rahim is all we need in this world. Where we live in a world where everyone is campaigning against silatul rahim. Everyone is campaigning for breaking of our family ties. You come and see Muhammad Mulidina, he was not the same. He wanted all the time to see that people, family members are united. Subhanallah. This is fantastic by itself. And this, the thawab of it is immense. Because silatul rahim Amirul Mu'minin Ali alayhi salam, you look at his wasiyah to al-imamain al-Hasan wal-Husayn alayhi salam, he says that silatul rahim, it is better than the salah and sawm of 1 year. Salah and sawm of 1 year cannot be compared to silatul rahim when you enjoin the family members. Muhammad Mulidina, rahmatullahi alayhi, he was such a person, always he wanted to see that the family will come together. And then you come to know that not only that, he used to do a lot of amal khair. Maybe he did not even tell other people what was he doing in his daily programs until when he met his death. May Allah reward him abundantly. Not only that, then you come to know that marhum told those closer people to him and his family that if Allah will make me to die, then know for sure there's no anything you need to do for me in terms of haqqullah. Not salah, not sawm, not khums, no zakah, nothing. If I die, I'll go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and there's no any debt. Where have we seen such a person in these days which we live in this world? But we hear many people when they pass away, family will have to pay back salah. They will have to do fastings and so many other haqqullah. But Muhammad Mulidina left this world the way we say, he left clean. May Allah reward him, increase his barakat and hasanat, inshallah. Then not only that, we come to know that Muhammad was tested. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him imtihan within the family, that there is a child. He has to take care of him. And he himself used to make sure he doesn't miss majalis. He will take good care of him. Subhanallah. After you have a long day of activities, but then at the same time, you remember other people who need to be taken care. Rahmatullahi alayh. And it is here, as we understand, for example, the young man, Abbas Mulidina, who is not well, he needs to be remembered in our dua, and we need to make sure we pray for him. We know that Muhammad made sure that always he will be there for Abbas. Now Muhammad has left this world. Those who are closer, we need all of us to be closer to Abbas in order for us to say, Abbas, yes, you lost Muhammad, but there will be other family members and other brothers who will be there to take care of you. And this shows us that when we do that which is khair, the khair will remain here. For the family, I know it is not easy. Wallah, it's not easy to bear. It's not easy at all to bear the calamity. When you know that the death happened on the 28th of Shahr Ramadan, and this is the time, near time of iftar. Can you imagine? Yeah, subhanallah. Sister, was preparing for iftar. Sister was aware that Brother Muhammad is coming back. Dada yetu pole sana. Brother Muhammad will come back to have iftar. Everything has been prepared. But then you receive the news that inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, we have lost someone so special within the family. This is a calamity. It is a musiba. It is a big musiba for any sister to lose the husband, and especially near the Eid. How many people had planned for Eid? With all the issues, lockdown and problems, but you can imagine that there was something. On the day of Eid, we'll do this. On the day of Eid, we'll do that. But then the news come that Muhammad is no longer with us. Subhanallah. It's a big test. But how can we be able to overcome this musiba? It's so difficult. But when we remember the musiba of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, then we come to understand that Imam Amirul Mu'mineen Ali alayhi salam, my dear brothers and sisters, when we remember Brother Muhammad Moledina and especially the family, there is nothing to console the family except to remember the musiba of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. The family of our brother Muhammad Moledina did not celebrate Eid. Because why? Muhammad was not there on the day of Eid. But then this reminds us about the musiba of Amirul Mu'mineen Ali alayhi salam. On the 21st of Shahar Ramadan, when Amirul Mu'mineen attained his Shahada, then you can come to know clearly that it was a big musiba for the family of Ali. There was no Eid for them. Can you imagine now on the 21st of Shahar Ramadan? That was the day Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas alayhim as-salam, they were the ones who were preparing the body of Imam Amirul Mu'mineen alayhi salam in order for them to bury their father just before the Eid, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And then when you look at the death of our brother Muhammad Moledina on the 28th of Shahar Ramadan, just near the Eid, while he was observing fasting and the thirst of Darussalam, can you imagine marhum passed away before iftar and how thirsty maybe he was? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. But then his thirst and his death reminds us about the death of Aba Abdullah and the Atasha of Karbala. When Imam Abi Abdullah told Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas to go and fetch water, then you can imagine how thirst the children, the women, and Aba Abdullah himself were on that particular day of Ashura in Karbala. And then when Imam Abi Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam was on the ground after the martyrdom of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, martyrdom of Ali al-Akbar, martyrdom of Ali al-Asghar, martyrdom of all the family members of Ahlul Bayt and the companions of Aba Abdullah, when Imam Abi Abdullah was on the ground just before he attained his Shahada, when he said, please give me some water, they did not give him any water and they started kicking Aba Abdullah al-Hussein salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. And this was a difficult for Abi Abdullah, and especially when they were kicking him and saying, you will not drink anything until when you reach and you meet your Lord. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. That was a calamity, especially to Sister Zainab. When Sayyida Zainab was watching, and Sayyida Zainab in one point, she said clearly, is there no any Muslim man or people to save Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam? But they didn't do so until when they slaughtered Aba Abdullah. Indeed, it was a calamity. And that's why Imam Sajjad alayhi salam, when he returned back to Medina, he used to pass by the butchers, and he used to say salam and ask the butchers, when they slaughtered the animals, did they give some water to them? They would say yes. And then Imam alayhi salam would cry and say, they slaughtered my father. They slaughtered my father. And they didn't give him any water. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا آل محمد أي منقلب ينقلبون ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Before we end this majlis, can I ask all the brothers and sisters to recite dua shafa'a amma yujibu al-muftarra for the marid who is within the family, inshallah, and all the marid. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. أما يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أما يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أما يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أَمَّا يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ أَمَّا يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ يَا اللَّهُ 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 اللَّهُمَّ اكْشِفْ عَنَّا السُّوءَ بِمَا شِئْتَ وَكَيْفَ شِئْتَ إِنَّكَ عَلَى مَا تَشَاءُ قَدِيرٌ اللَّهُمَّ شَافِ كُلَّ مَرِيضٍ اللهم شافي كل مريض اللهم شافي كل مريض برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين رحم الله من قرأ الفاتحة مسبوقة بالصلاة على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله